If you're watching this video, I bet you've played an MMO before, a massively multiplayer online role-playing game. Now, these games, they are more than just video games. They are whole other worlds that you can get lost in and be whoever you want to be, whether that being a big mean orc, a boring human, or just a sexy elf. But why are these games so good? What keeps us coming back time and time again to play these games that consume our lives? Greetings everybody, my name is Nixium, and welcome back to another video. But first, a word from our sponsor, My Games. Are you tired of feeling like an overpowered adventurer in every MMO?
Yeah.
Then why not skip the grind and become a literal god in Skyforge?
I think I will.
Choose one of over 18 classes and become an immortal deity, one who repels alien invaders that seek to slaughter your worshippers.
Nice.
It is the perfect time to jump into the game too, because over the next 3 weeks, Skyforge is celebrating Alien Day, an event that brings new missions to the game along with exclusive anniversary costumes to earn.
Nice.
5 years of Skyforge, and with this update, we are seeing Nightmare Challenges added to the game for those of you that love extreme difficulty. Phytonite Invasions have also arrived, which are multiple in-game challenges that offer up to 30 tiers of rewards through the purchase of an Invasion Pass. Scale up the ranks, get yourself the Divine Form Wakan, some Petal Wings, or even the Phytomorph costume just for having supported the game and gotten a pass. Click the link down below in the description, you simple adventurer, and upgrade to godhood today. Or just keep farming boars like a loser. The first thing that probably comes to your mind on why MMOs are so good is the community. I mean, that's what the first thing that comes to my mind is. There is really no other game genre out there that comes close to the type of community building that MMOs foster. You need to make friends in these games to actually progress. Oh, except in BFA. Sorry, is that Corona? Oh, God. These are whole other worlds with events, drama, relationships that form over time. There is no pause button in the worlds of Azeroth, Tamriel, and whatever MMO we're talking about. It doesn't matter. Now, when you look back at your most memorable moments when playing an MMO, what do you think of? Not really, like, go into the comments right now and tell me the most memorable moment you have ever had playing WoW, ESO, any MMO, RuneScape, I don't know. I'll wait. Now, I bet for a majority of the people, those moments were not spent by yourself, right? When an MMO shines the brightest, it's when you are just hanging out with your pals and experiencing the game with them. Because at the end of the day, you're gonna consume the content. You're gonna kill the boss. You're going to, I don't know, you're gonna get the achievement. But your friends, the community, and the people that you play with, it's gonna keep you playing the game. My YouTube channel is filled with so many stories of my first time making a friend in World of Warcraft to how I got my first mount in Classic WoW for free in WoW. There's tons to choose from, tons of memories that I've chosen to share with you guys, and so share your memories with us down in the comment section below. Let me tell you guys, in terms of memorable moments, I've got a ton of them. Dude, I used to play on a roleplay server. You guys ever played on a roleplay server in an MMO before? It's crazy. 1 second, you're meeting fucking Link from The Legend of Zelda, and the next second, you're encountering two Fuda Night Elf women putting daggers inside of their assholes. And you think I'm kidding? I ain't kidding. All right? It's weird, and I love it. The sheer madness of it. But there's also, like, normal things as well, like, hey man, like, I've seen people gift gold to new players. I've seen veteran players organize funerals for people who passed away behind the scenes in real life. And I love it. That community element is fantastic, because everything that happens in the real world, including the daggers and the asses and shit, it happens in the MMO, just in a fantastical, pixelated sort of way. And how cool is that? The social aspect of the game is what makes them so replayable, because there's an infinite amount of possibilities of the adventures that you can go on and the people that you will meet. Now, one player, they might have the experience of joining a guild full of friendly players who all hold hands and, you know, have a magical drama-free adventure.
I declare today, Happy Friendship Sunshine Day. Let us forever remember that violence is never the answer.
And on the other hand, you know, it can happen. Another player can join a guild that is literally a cesspool of hatred, filled with 58 death knights, toxic neckbeards, and tons of drama.
A complete waste of a life you are. Go jump off a cliff, you insignificant ball of gay.
That hurts, man.
Your experience playing any MMO is formed around the people you play with, and having social ties in the game makes the whole experience of actually playing an MMO much more impactful because of your actions directly relating to other players on the other side of the screen. Oh, yeah. It's a mouthful, guys. All I'm trying to say is all this, it makes the social aspect of the MMO sort of like a mechanic of a game. Of the game, in a weird way. Like, if you ninja loot an item off a boss, that will have serious repercussions on how you even play the game, because you will be banished from ever playing with any group of players that have heard about you. You know? You build a reputation as being an asshole. But don't worry, guys, we're not here just to talk about the community, because another reason why someone might ninja loot an item, just had a thought. You know, it kind of ties into another aspect that makes MMOs so good. And you know what that is? Being better than other people. Now listen, guys, there is no better feeling than being that one dude standing in the main city who has the best gear in town. People look up to you like you are some sort of god. You are a player that has achieved greatness, and you have become a person that other people have dreamed of becoming. Look at you. You're just incredible. The social status of having the best items in the game is that carrot on the stick that everybody is trying to chase so that they can be that god gamer that other players can marvel at. But what they don't know is that the person that does have the best gear is actually living in their mom's basement, and they've been playing the game for about 18 hours a day for the past 6 months. But if you ignore that, they look like a badass in game, and that's really all that matters, right? You know, it's kind of cool, like that hierarchy of the community, you know, the badasses and... You guys know what I'm talking about. Another thing that makes MMOs so fucking awesome, I'm just gonna be legit. Alright, like in relation to gear and being the best geared player on the server, like, why do we go out and get the best gear, guys? Like, come on, why are you trying to get that helmet, that sword, that whatever? I'll tell you why you're trying to do it. So that you can kick other people's asses. That's right, cue the fucking metal music. Dude, you go into battlegrounds and shit, going into Warsong Gulch, boom, getting your ass fucking kicked. You go into Arathi Basin, boom, you go into Ultric Valley. Yeah, you ain't gonna get into Ultric Valley, the server queue's a bit too long. But you get the idea, boom, yeah, good, get fucked. That's one of the best parts about getting more gear in an MMO. You know, getting better gear just kind of turns you into a badass, and everybody recognizes you as a badass, except for your mom. You know, she just keeps yelling at you to go outside and mow the lawn. Fuck you, mom, I'm busy. I'm sitting in my Ultric Valley queue. Could pop any second. Bitch, the progression of your character is a big aspect of any MMO, and it's what you will spend the majority of your time working towards. There is always something that you can do to progress your character, whether that be farming gold, collecting gear, collecting mounts, transmog pets. Look, you can waste years of your life playing these games and trying to complete it, let's be real. And that is the great thing about MMOs. The game never ends. It's just chaos. You can do whatever you want. If you want to start a giant conga line of people from one side of the planet to the other, you can do it. If you want to raid a capital city, you can do that too. You want to make a shit ton of gold and start like a freaking mafia in an MMO? Well, you can do that. The possibilities are endless. The sheer sandbox chaos of an MMO, that too is what makes these games so fascinating. You can play the game for hours and hours a day. You'll never run out of stuff to do. Imagine playing a game like Nintendogs for the DS for 18 hours a day. You can't do that. Well, maybe someone can. Like you. Yeah, you listening to this right now, freak. You can only pet a puppy for so long, okay? Until it gets boring. MMOs aren't like that. They're like whole other worlds where you can just do whatever you want. When you want, with whoever you want, and there are no real restrictions on what aspect of the game you can tackle at that moment. So yeah, go level that character. Go raid. Dance naked on the mailbox for money. Why the hell not? And that, my friends, is my short little discussion on why I think MMOs are so much fun. It's a world of endless opportunity where you can do whatever you please in a community that is crafted through experience and killing elite mobs and shit. But what do you guys think? Why do you guys find MMOs so fun? What are your favorite MMOs? I'd like to know what you guys think in the comment section below. Do not forget to like the video and subscribe and hit the bell and all that crap. Thank you to the patrons who make these videos happen and all the people on the join feature here on YouTube. And I will see you guys later.